Ma'am, wait.
Yes,
yes,
ma'am. Yes,
start.
Start. Okay. So, good morning to one and all. Good morning to one and all. With the blessings of our founder, Chairman, sir, late Dr. S. M. Venkatapathy ji, sir, and on behalf of the Department of Science, I mean Basic Science, and EPCT organizing team, we heartily welcome our beloved Eng CEOs, Shri Mr. Pramod Gowda, sir, and Shri Mr. Rajiv Gowda, sir. I extend my warm welcome to the guest and the keynote speaker, Dr. V. Lokesh, sir. And I also welcome our beloved principal, Dr. S. Prakash, sir. And I also welcome Dr. G. Maruti, sir, the HOD of Physics Department.
Thank you.
And I also welcome Dr. Doraiswamy, sir, the HOD of Mathematics Department. And I welcome all HODs of EPCET and my dear colleagues and participants to the Day 2 Asset 2021. Now I request our beloved principal, Dr. S. Prakash, sir, to welcome our honorable guest and keynote speaker. So over to you, sir.
Yeah. Thank you. It's a privilege and honor to host Dr. Lokesh, sir. Sir, thank you for being with us, taking your time, and we hope to listen to you, sir. We are all eager to listen to your keynotes as a keynote speaker. Madam, is it something I need to speak, Gayatri? You want me to speak
more time? Yeah, you can introduce, sir.
Okay. No, I don't have his profile. I think someone can introduce him. How is it?
Yes, sir. Doraiswamy, sir, will give a brief introduction to it.
Yes. Okay. Then I don't think so. But once his session starts, I think you can start introducing. Yesterday, we inaugurated the international conferences. I was speaking about the importance of basic science and engineering. There is no technology without basic science. Unfortunately, even I told yesterday, somewhere in our education system, we missed out basic science. More specifically, today I see the in a lot of engineering college students also resistance towards mathematics. It's very unfortunate. We are getting it back. I want to tell just few things. How basically mathematics today, the topic is mathematics here. The right person is Lokesh, sir, who is speaking about mathematics. But I want to tell few things what actually India gave to the world. World's first from India. I want to just speak about this. It all started with a zero. Mathematician Aryabhatta was the first person to create a symbol for zero. And it was through his efforts that mathematical operations like addition and subtraction started using digit zero. This was the first what we gave. So we need to know all these things. And I want to tell even friends with numbers, number of friends, that's us what India gave. We gave the friends of numbers. India gave the indigenous method of expressing all numbers by means of 10 symbols, the decimal system. Each symbol received a value of position and an absolute value. India gave this. I also want to tell something. What again India gave? Millions ago, we got the year right. No one got the year right. We got the year right. The Hindu cosmological time cycles explained in the Surya Siddhanta somewhere in the 600 BC gave the average length of sidereal year, an accurately close value of 365.2563627 days, which is only 1.4 seconds longer than the modern day value. No one predicted the value like us. India was the first to predict it. See, I'm just telling the importance of mathematics and what India gave in terms of mathematics. World's first ever from India again. It could be 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34. this all series which was given by India to the world in 300 BC. This is nothing than other than Fibonacci series. Fibonacci series came from India. And the first sequence in Indian mathematics as Matra Miru, okay, mentioned by the Pinagala in the connection with Sanskrit tradition of prosody. The application of Fibonacci series can be seen in the poetry of such legends as Hemchandra rather than mundane mathematical theorems and dry logic. See, these are the first few things what Indians actually gave to the world. Even there are a few things, we have been seen the first vision which was given, the first cataract surgery is said to have been performed by the ancient Indian physician Sushruta way back in the 6th century BC. To remove a cataract from the eyes, he used a curved needle which was named as Jadamukhi Salaka to loosen the lens and push the cataract out of the field of vision. The needle was invented by Indians somewhere in 6th century BC. There are a lot of things, unfortunately, we have forgotten our history. I want to tell you what came from India. Only the son of this soil got the sun right. We got the sun right. Aryabhatta's Aryabhatiyam represented the pinnacle of astronomical knowledge at that time. He correctly propounded that the earth is round, rotates on its own axis, and revolves around the sun. The heliocentric theory was given by India. We were the first to give to this to the world. I also take some time. The best of metallurgy is powered by India's energy. Many people went wrong, but we were the first to give this. The pioneering steel alloy matrix developed in India. Ode steel is a crucible steel characterized by the pattern of bands that was known in the ancient world by many different names such as Ukku, Indwani, and Ceric iron. This was used to make the framed Damasus swords that could cleave a free-falling silk craft or a block of wood with the same ease. So this was there with us. This all falls to mathematics. Okay. I also want to tell rocket launchers. First rocket launches was done by Indians in 15th century. We were talking about that in the 15th century. The first iron cast rockets were developed in the late 15th century in the Kingdom of Mysore, adopted and improved as the Congreve rocket and used in the Napoleonic Wars. We gave rocket science. Another beautifully about India is all about Sushruta Samhita is considered to be one of the most comprehensive textbooks on ancient surgery. Sushruta's contribution to plastic surgery is the reconstruction of the nose, known also as rhinoplasty. Surgery actually was invented, plastic surgery was invented from India. So, dear friends, another story of India is that India inched towards engineering way back in 3000 BC. Not now, it's not in AD, in 3000 BC. Excavations at Harappan sites have yielded rulers or linear measures made from ivory and shell, marked out in minute subdivisions with amazing accuracy. The calibrations correspond closely with the haste increments of 13 by 8 inches, traditionally used in the ancient architecture of South India. So, we Indians need to be proud that we invented a lot and gave a lot to the world. So, there is another one story that there lived 10 kinds of people. That's Indians, we told to the world. And those who learned from us. The binary number system was first described by the Vedic scholar called as Pingala. Many people don't know about this. We think that binary system is from some other people from Europe. No. in this is this book, Chanda Shastra, which is the earliest known as Sanskrit treatise. So there is a lot what we have given to India, to the world. Another one, a thought that was once small, powerful, indestructible. One of the notable scientists of the ancient India was Kanada, who is said to have devised the atomic theory centuries before John Dalton. He speculated the existence of anu, or a small indestructible particle, much like an atom. He also stated that anu can have two states. One is absolute rest and another one is a state of motion. He further held that atoms of same substances combined with each other in a specific and synchronized manner to produce dvyanka, that is diatomic molecules, and trionka, that is triatomic molecules. So, dear friends, we should be proud that we have given lot to the world. So, why did I tell all these things? Is we carry, genetically carry mathematics. Indians genetically carry maths. So, all my engineering students, my message, those who are watching live, for any technology, it is mathematics. Today, you see any innovations that has happened, mathematics is the core. Mathematics is, every time I keep on telling my PhD research scholars, anything you invent, anything architecture you evolve, mathematical model becomes the fundamental. So, you take mobile phone, there is a specifications for everything. There is a chemistry specifications, there is a battery specifications, there is a processor specifications, there is a RAM specifications, there is a display specifications called as a resolution specifications. Everything boils to mathematics. So all my research scholars, one thing, whenever you are pursuing PhD, kindly understand one thing, you need to have a mathematical model embedded in your research component. So today I request everyone, in fact, this is what told by my guide when I was doing my PhD. He told that you are doing excellent product which makes a 5G, 4G wireless communications. My research was on 4G wireless communications. But he was insisting me to come out with a mathematical model to pre your POC. That is your proof of your concept. Fine. So all my message to all my research scholars is that we as Indians genetically carry mathematics. Okay, we have given a lot to the world, what I told till now. These are all, and if I keep on telling what all we have given, I have this list, what I've just reading it out, it's very huge list. I don't want to actually keep on, some other time I want to tell you what all we gave to world. Okay, so make mathematics as an important subject in all your research. There is no research gets completed in engineering without mathematics. Don't leave mathematics, because we are acquainted with mathematics from our ancestors. We'll continue this journey. Dr. Lokesh sir is the right person to speak about how actually mathematics becomes very, very important component in any of the research today. Taking forward and seeing him the next speech, I'll be eager to listen to him also. Okay. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. Whenever always people tell me that I need to not be given take over the stage. If I take over the stage, I'll keep on speaking. Thank you, Marthi sir, and all the professors of basic science. Congratulating once again. All the best for this day also. Thank you. Over to you, Gayatri.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you, sir, for your words and for your
encouragement. Yes, sir, there is a famous saying that as you keep on telling, science is very important for technology. And also a famous physicist, Feynman, says, every science discovery leads to 3,000 innovations in the engineering and technology. And it is again and again, it is proving. Even today also, sir, if you see the COVID vaccine, in fact, our Indian vaccine is much ahead of than the even the Oxford Pfizer, this one vaccine. There are many repercussions in the foreign vaccine, but if you see our own vaccine, there is no much a problem with that. It's a proof that yes, we are also capable. Thank you for your encouraging words, and definitely for the youngsters, it is very, very encouraging. Thank you, sir. I think as you mentioned, it is a time for Lokesh, sir. We are also eager to listen to the Lokesh, sir. Now, I think the Duraiswamy sir will give a very, very brief introduction about the Lokesh, sir, and then Lokesh, sir, will take over the session. So, thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank
Over
you, sir.
To
yes.
you, Duraiswamy sir.
Yes, sir.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, our principal, Dr. Prakash, sir.
Good morning,
sir. And Lokesh, sir.
Good morning.
It's a great pleasure for me to introduce our speaker, Dr. V. Lokesh, MSc, PhD, and Doctor of Science, professor and chairman, Department of Studies in Mathematics, Vijayanagara, Sri Krishnadevaraya University, Bellary. Dr. V. Lokesh has served various positions in the field of education, like coordinator for Doctor of Science in Computer Science from 2014 to 2016, and Board of Science Chairman for Mathematics from 2016 to 2019, and Chairman for Doctor of Science in Mathematics from 2014 to 2018, and he served a nodal officer of Bellary Center KSET examination of 2020, and he served finance committee member of Vijayanagara Sri Krishnadevaraya University 2019 to till date, and he is academic council member of Vijayanagara Sri Krishnadevaraya University from 2019 to 2021, and he served deputy registrar for administration of Vijayanagara Sri Krishnadevaraya University in the year 2014, and he served special officers academic as well as evaluation from 2014 to 2019, and he was the registrar evaluation in the year 2019. Dr. V. Lokesh, having more than 25 years of teaching experience as well as research, he published more than 175 papers in international and national journals. So his Google Scholar citation is 912H index 16. He's reviewed American Mathematical 51 times, and Gentroblatt reviews 142 times. He visited many countries like Canada, Iran, Turkey, France, South Korea for research activities. Dr. V. Lokesh received Karnataka State Award for research publication with cash prize of ₹25,000 in the year 2016-2017. He published 6 books with Dr. Padmanabhan. He is editor-in-chief for the Journal of Analysis and Computation, Journal of Intelligent System Research, Serial Publication, New Delhi. He is editor for Palestinian Journal of Mathematics, actually that is Scopus Indexed Journal, and executive editor of Bulletin of Pure and Applied Mathematics. He is advisory board and consultant editor for various journal of mathematics. So on the behalf of East Point College of Engineering and Technology, I am heartily welcome to our valuable speech from Lokesh. We are expecting valuable speech from Lokesh. So I am heartily welcome to Lokesh, sir. So now I hand over to Lokesh, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your words, sir.
Sir, Lokesh, sir, 1 minute, sir. Actually, this is the bouquet.
Thank you,
so
sir.
So we presented you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, it's a welcome you from in presence of Principal Sir, Maruti Sir, and Duraiswamy Sir.
Thank you, sir. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers. I know in this tenure, you've done an excellent job. First of all, I would thank Professor Prakash Sir, Principal, IPCET. He gave a good guidelines about the mathematics. In engineering college, I also served around 15 years. I know how the people are doing in mathematics. Mathematics people will always helping to all the departments. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your cooperation to the basic science departments. And also a special thanks to Doraiswamy. He always calling me and telling, thank you, sir. Thank you for inviting me for this, giving opportunity for giving a lecture. I know some of the little things I will share with the people. And also I thank Dr. Maruti, sir. Thank you, sir. And also Gayatri is assisting all the coordination. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let us, I will start my talk. I can share, ma'am.
Sir, yes, sir, you can share the screen, sir.
Madam, is it visible?
Just a minute, sir. Just a minute, sir. Sir, can you share your screen, sir?
Yes, shared, ma'am.
It's not visible, sir. Can you try once more, sir? Yes, sir. One second. I'll add it to the screen.
Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good morning, one and all, present in this conference. Let us start with my title of the talk, Numerical Graph Invariant, its Scenery and Shared Association. Why I can choose this numerical graph invariant means, you know that this is the combination of both physics, mathematics, as well as chemistry. These are the three important basic sciences conferences, this one. That's why I thought this is the better talk. It is useful to all the departments. Let us start with this numerical graph invariants. Actually, this the graph invariant is the one of the important topic. In the last 30 years, it has a almost a huge number of papers are came for the research point of view. First, I will, in the outline of my talk, for the time of 3 decades, hefty number of numerical graph invariants are defined. Almost nowadays, around 6,000, more than 6,000 topological indices are defined. Some of them are well-versed, and also some of the applications related to theoretical chemistry, as well as pharmacology, toxicology, and environmental chemistry. These are the main important thing. And also, Professor, telling about the COVID-19. In the COVID-19 situation also, some of the topological indices, the covaccine related area also, we can check mathematically using this, one of our professor, Professor Kulli from Darwad. He is working on the structural methods related to COVID-19 papers also done by in numerical invariant. These are the same important things I want to start with this. In this talk, I would like to brief some of the basic definition, how the topological indices are introduced, how the basic structure, and some of the recent topological indices, how they generate, and also how the application point of view we can study the topological indices, and what are the softwares available for studying this topological indices. These are the three important section I want to discuss here. Here, for the convenience, these are the some classified according to their logical derivation, topological indices rather than according to the sequential growth. Structural compaction is one of the most important and least investigating property of the topological molecular descriptor. Here, I plan to present some works and avenues allied to the topological indices. First, I will start with what is molecular topology. Suppose a molecule M is composed of n atoms, A1, A2, etc., AN. Suppose also that for two atoms, AI and AJ, we can decide which of the two statements are correct. In the molecule M, there is a chemical bond between the atoms A1, AI and AJ. Or in the molecule M, the atoms AI and AJ are not chemically bonded. Then the totality of the information about the mutual connectedness of all pair of atoms in a molecule determines the topology for the respective molecule. Means we can study the totality of the information about the atoms, then only we get a topology of a molecule. There are several ways in which the information on the mutual connectedness of atoms in a molecule can be recorded. The pictorial representation, which we shall describe now, can be easily grasped by organic chemists because of its close resemblance to the structural formula. What is molecular topology? Represent each atom by a small circles, draw a line, not necessarily a straight line, between any two circles which corresponds to a chemically bonded atoms. The diagram obtained in this manner is a graph. Since it represents the molecular topology, it will become be called as a molecular graph. You can see here, consider an example of ethanol here and represents its topology as described here. For our convenience, we can label here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Then we can make this by molecular graph of ethanol. You can see first we can draw, then we can make a graphical representation using dot and lines. After that, where the topology of a molecule represents a molecular graph is an essentially non-numerical mathematical object. Various measurable properties of a molecules are usually expressed by means of numbers. In order to link a molecular topology to any real property, molecular property, one must first convert the information contained in the molecular graph into a numerical characteristic. First, now we will deal with a graph invariant. Every number which is uniquely determined by a graph is called graph invariant. The invariants of a molecular graph, which are used for structural property and structural activity correlation, are usually called as topological indices. This is corresponding to a particular molecule also. You know that a topological indices must be meet the requirement. If suppose if you take two G1 and G2 are two graphs are isomorphic, then topological indices of G1 is equal to topological indices of G2. But you must remember the reverse of this statement by no means true. Generally, it is not true. You must remember if Ti G1 is equal to Ti G2, then the graph G1 and G2 need not be isomorphic. Now we will discuss about some of the topological indices. That starts with the Wiener index. Actually, basically, there are three types of topological indices are defined and also discussed in a large scale. One is distance-based, another one is degree-based, and another one is neighborhood based. These are the three fundamental things. Now it is correlated with distance based as well as degree based. Both is merged, and also some of the neighborhood topological indices are coming to the picture. Now I will start with the Hernold Wiener. He is the first introduced and defined as the sum of all the distances between the pairs of vertices U and V in a graph G is called as W of G is equal to, that is, D of degree of U comma V. If there is an edge between U and V, then we can make a sum of this. And in 1993, Milan Randick introduced a distance-based quantity. He named it as Hyper-Wiener Index, and it is denoted by HW. Its definition could be applied only to the trees and was possible to use cycle-containing graph. These are the definition, and in the degree distance was introduced by Dobrin and Kochetova as a weighted version of the Wiener index. The degree distance of G, that is DD of G, is defined in this way. And harmonic index is given by H of G, that is summation 2 by DU plus DV. And the geometric arithmetic index of G, that is GA of G, and it is denoted by this one. This is and the first and second Zagreb. This is the fundamental Zagreb indices. These are the more important relationship, and also these many applications related to first and second Zagreb indices are generated. But we know and first, second and Zagreb indices are the fundamental concept to study topological indices. You must remember this. Now I will go on to some of the graph operations with an example. You know that line graph L of G is a graph with vertex set V of L is equal to E of G, and whose vertices corresponds to the edges of G, with two vertices being adjacent if and only if the corresponding edge of G have a vertex in common. This is one of the reference book. It is not only line graph, and it related to many operators in a graph operators are there. That's why I mentioned for the reference for this. And subdivision graph, you can take any graph. You can put one in between the edge, there is a edge. Then what happens in a line, that becomes, it divides into two. Means S of G is a graph obtained from G by replacing each of its edges by a path of length 2, or equivalently by we saying that inserting an additional vertex into each edge of G. Here are some of the relationship related to subdivision graph. Our collaborators, we done one of the beautiful paper on certain topological indices of a derived graph of subdivision graph. Now I will deal with some more definitions related to vertex semitotal graph that can be usually denoted by T1 of G. Some of the authors is referred as R of G. With vertex set V of G union E of G, and edge set is E of S union E of G, if the graph obtained from G by adding a new vertex corresponding to each edge of G by joining each new vertex to the end vertices of the edge corresponding to it. This is the original graph we are choosing here. You can see. Then first we can introduce by the using the definition of this. First we will introduce here there is an edge is there. That's why here we introduce one of the point. Here also we can introduce. Then again here, then these two we can introduce. Then we can join this. We get a vertex semitotal graph of this graph. Similarly, an edge semitotal graph, that is T2 of G, some of them are referred as Q of G, with the vertex set V of G union E of G, and edge set is E of S subdivision union E of L, means it is a line and this is a subdivision. Obtaining from G by inserting a new vertex into each edge of G, and by joining with edges, those pair of these new vertices which lie on the adjacent edges of G. Here you can see this diagram here. First, we can make a subdivision for this, graph. Then this become here, you get one, here one, and here there are 4 points. Then after that, getting this, we can make a line relationship 1, 2, here there is a relation, then this. Then you get an edge semi-total graph of this one. Similarly, the totality of the graph, usually the it combined with both semi-total and semi-total vertex and edge. Similarly here, the total graph of G is denoted by T of G with vertex set V of G union E of G of any two vertices of T of G are adjacent if and only if they are either incident or adjacent in G. You can see this diagram, original graph. First, we can make a subdivision, then you can make a join, then you get a complete. Again, similarly, the first semi-vertex, you can see here, then it is the total graph of any graph G. Now, the jump graph. The jump graph J of G of a graph G is graph defined by E of G, and in which two vertices are adjacent if and only if they are not adjacent in G. This is the original graph you can see. First, we can make here AB and AB, DE, AC, where there is adjacency, we don't have adjacency. You can see here A and D, there is no adjacent, that's why we can make an adjacent. Similarly, CD is here, B is not adjacent to D, then we can make it. This is known as jump graph of G. These are the some of the graph operators we can utilize for in a chemical structures. Now we will go on to a graph operations with an example. Let us define a paraline graph of a graph G. This is the one of the important structural operator is useful in chemical analysis. This is the paraline graph of G. Given a graph G, insert two vertices to each edge xy of G. Those two vertices will be denoted by x comma y and y comma x. You already know how to write the chemical molecular graph to a graph structure. This is the graph. We can make a graph. After that, we can make a paraline graph. This is the paraline graph of a graph G. Let us define the paraline graph is a popular, I already mentioned, in the interdisciplinary of chemistry as well as graph theory. These are some of example. I already mentioned this. This is C6H6. Molecular graph of hydrocarbons. Then this is a graph of C6H6. This is the paraline graph of C6H6. Now there is a combination of the graphs. The tensor product of G and H is the graph with the vertex set V of G into V of H, two vertices UI and VJ, and UK and VJ being adjacent in G cross H if and only if UI UJ belongs to edge set. Similarly, vertex set VI VJ belongs to edge set of H. Then the tensor product of P3 graph path of 3 and C5, that is cycle, is illustrated. This one you can see here, this is a cycle C5 and this is a path P2. Then we can make a tensor product of P2 and C5. This is the tensor product of P2 and C5. First, we can make A1, A2, A3, A4, and A5. These are the edge set. Then here, sorry, point. Then we can make here B1, B2, B3, B4, and B5. These are points. Then we can make a relationship, make a joining. We get a tensor product of P2 and C5. Because the tensor product was introduced by Alfred North, Whitehead, and Bertrand in Russell in 1912. It is also equivalent to our Kronecker product of the adjacency matrices of graph. The cross symbol shows visually the two edges resulting from the tensor product of two edges. The tensor product is also known as direct product, categorical product. Depending on their structure, they are some of the physicists and cardinal product, relationship product, Kronecker product, and weak direct product are conjunction. These are the words they are utilized there for the purpose. Whatever we discuss the for the connected graph, the operators. Now we will discuss, let us define four related graph of S of G, R of G, Q of G, and total graph as follows. Here it is clear from the definition of that the Kronecker product. We can write V of S of G in this way. These are the relationship equality, and the R of G, E of its set of R of G is equal to E of G union E of S of G, and Q of G relationship with line and subdivision, and total graph is the graph with line graph and subdivision graph. The union, these are the sum of the relationship we can observe carefully. And also we must remember the G, L of G and S of G are mutually disjoint. These are the some of the examples illustrate the subdivision and operators graph. This is S of subdivision of C3, R of C3, C3, this is C3, S of subdivision, this is R of C3, this is Q of C3 and T of C3. These are some of the examples related to graph operations. And this is F sum graph, G, F sum graph of G. We extended these things from F sum graph. Let us take F is equal to belongs to S, R, Q, and T. Is defined as the vertex set is in this form and get set is can be denote in this way. There is the references. I will give you the example related to this F sum graph. You can see here this is F of G1, G2, G3 will be there. Here G1, G2, G are the relationship with the F sum graph of this. AI, AJ, black vertices, BIJ, BR, white vertices. These are the references related to F sum graph. Now graph operations with example. After the operation, suppose G and H are two connected graph. Based on these operations, we define the four new operations on the graph, that is cycle of 4 and cycle of 5 with our these are the diagram. You can see here P2 F sum graph in related to subdivision with C4 and P2, and this is the P2 and C4 with respect to R operator, and this is the graph P2 and C4 with a Q operator, and this one is P2 and C4 graph operator. These are the sum of the after the operation you get some chemical relationship that we can identify using math. Now we will give one of the new topological indices is recently introduced by one of my scholar, that is Deepika T. He will see the impact of this index in this area of research. After his finding the VL index, the many other authors are done some relationship and also chemical operations related to this VL index. Means after that they are introduced VL temperature index, VL status index, and many more relationship related to this. That's why I'm started with this. Many avenues are there in this VL index. The mathematical measure defines with the chemical nature, purporting for the correlation of chemical structure. with various physical properties. Chemical reactivity or biological activity is known as topological index, I already mentioned. In an explicit phrase, the topology of G and topology of GH are isomorphic, then only we can discuss the new topological indices can be defined. Obviously, the number of vertices and the number of edges are two basic parameters in topological indices. In recent decade, a large number of topological indices have been defined and utilized for the chemical documentation and isomer discrimination. The study of molecular complexity, similarity and QSAR and QSPR studies, drug design, database selection, lead optimization are utilized in the topological indices. Chemical reaction cause changes in entropy. Entropy play an important role in determining in which direction a chemical reaction spontaneously proceeds. The role of enthalpy of a vaporization is to transform the quantity of a substance from a liquid into a gaseous state at a given pressure. Furthermore, physical properties of an octane and polychlorinated biphenylene, that is, we can say short form, that is PCB, as their vital roles in the chemical application. These are the some of the background we have discussed, and already I mentioned the Goodman and Tresnik discussed the Zagreb indices, that is the most useful topological indices. They are denoted by M1 of G and M2 of G in this way. Alternatively, the first and second Zagreb indices is equivalent to the sum of the squares of the degrees of the vertices, and second is equal to the second Zagreb index is equal to the sum of the product of the degrees of pair of adjacent vertices of the underlying molecular graph. Many researchers are working in this Zagreb indices, and one of the theses related to the Zagreb indices and applications are done by Ranjini and their co-authors. They are extended a various version, and it is also most important part of the research because it have a many application in the field of chemical sciences. This is the VL index she defined. You can see here VL of G is equal to off into summation of DE plus DF plus 4. These are the relationship what is DE and DF is discussed. This is the degree of vertices of U and V in G respectively. Now I move on to directly the correlation with the molecular structure with the VL index. The coming table shows the correlation between the physical properties of PCB and octane isomer and VL index respectively. You know the correlation coefficient measure, it is how strongly a pair of variables are related. You know that 1 and minus 1, the correlation is between minus 1 to 1, then only we say that it is correlated. Depending on the value, we can say that it is highly correlated, lowly correlated, then we can check that depending on the values. Here, this is one of the examples related to this VL index he mentioned. The treadmill, the calorie burned can be given example for this. It is usually varies between minus 1 to 1. And if it is closer to 1, the variables are said to be highly linearly proportioned. And if it is close to minus 1, then highly linearly inversely proportioned. If R is close to 0, then there is no relationship. We can see in the coming table the physical properties of octane isomers with VL index is inversely proportional to closer to minus 1. You can see here the physical properties of octane isomers, entropy values, and HVAP, that is enthalpy vaporization, and standard enthalpy of vaporization, ascentic factor, and physical property of PCB R is relative retention time. You can see here all the values, it is inversely correlated and one is highly correlated. These are the applications in that VL index is discussed. The following figure shows the graph that variable coincides with each other. Here the coefficient of R square, the how the measure of the variance in enthalpy is explained by the regression model. Often you know that model traces close to the actual values of coefficient of determination is high, else the model needs to be improved upon. These are the some of the things related to VL index with the enthalpy. The R square linear is 0.923. And similarly, enthalpy of vaporization, you can see here that value is 0.650. And some more VL index with the standard enthalpy of vaporization, that value is 0.771. And with respect to VL index, ascentic factor is the R square linear is R 0.979. And relative retention time with respect to VL index is 0.894. That's why we say that this VL index is useful for the correlation of physical properties. Further, recently one of our research scholars, Suvarna, is introduced VL status index and co-indices of some standard graph. This paper may be published in Journal of Mathematics in the 2021 issue. Here, this is the VL status index. I'm simply giving a brief because this is a newly introduced index. The many properties can be studied with this with a chemical structure. And this is the VL status index as well as co-indices and how to discuss about the VL index with respect to this graph VLS of G and also the status index of the co-indices of this graph. And the correlation of VL status index and some properties of butane derivatives. PSPR studies from the very beginning of its journey sees the attention of both mathematicians as well as chemists, since it has the potential to be cause of new innovations. Especially, finding the properties of a compound without any experimentation, it is actually time consuming. That's why the mathematics will play an important role in the chemical structure and as well as topological indices. Here we observe that VLS of good correlation with all the three physical properties, save surface tension, complexity and heavy atomic count. Correlation coefficient value, that is, you can see here, it is nearer to one. That is surface tension, complexity and heavy atomic count respectively. These are the table correlated with VLS of surface tension, complexity, heavy atomic count. VLS is the depending on the butanian things, he verified the values with respect to correlation. These are the structure you can see here. There is how it is correlated and the correlation of this VL status index and some properties of butane derivatives you already seen in the table. The scatter plot between the surface tension, heavy atomic count and VLS index of butane derivative is shown these three diagrams. These are the sum of the how the application, how it is the defined index is helpful to study the chemical structures. And also she discussed about some bounds related to VL status index. Depending on the mathematical point of view, G is a connected graph with n vertices and the diameter of G is equal to D, is represented by D, then these are the inequality of time. Similarly, the bounds related to minimum and maximum degree related to vertices of G, this is the one of the relationship also derived. And related to that graph, there are connected graph of a regular graph. a particular regular graph of degree r with n vertices, then this is the relationship holds. And also, she studied some of the standard graph of VL status index relationship of VL status index of complete graph, complete bipartite graph, cycle, wheel, and windmill graph, and many more. These are the few examples related to this. This is a path graph relationship and cycle of CN and wheel and some friendship graph. These are the some few examples related to mathematically they can study. And co-indices also structured and characterize the equality of their bounds also. You can see that paper, you get more idea related to this VL status index and co-indices. Now, my main concentration related to some applications of topological indices. You know that it is a multidisciplinary journal. One of them is Journal of Jianjin Mathematical Society. In that, the Usha and his team done one of the paper related to topological indices of model graph structure of alveoli in human lungs. This is the reference. And in that paper, the alveoli of human lungs are considered as a graph. And the topological indices, they have chosen some topological indices which are more appropriate, that they are chosen and determined for both healthy lungs and enzema affected alveoli using the operator double graph. In order to understand the structure and functioning of the lungs, the passage of air through the intake, nose and mouth must be studied. Inside, the air passes through the windpipe, which divides into two main branches, that these branches of the left and right lungs, where they progressively subdivide into a system of bronchi and bronchioles until the alveoli is reached. These alveoli help in exchange of carbon dioxide and oxygen across the thin membrane. And she's taken that as a double graph, which is basically a graph used to represent two graphs at once with the same number of vertices. The neighbors of a vertex are joined in the image of the graph in exactly the same manner. This is the change in the lung disease. You can see here, pneumonia, healthy and emphysema, affected area. Then she converted into a double graph model. In this double graph model, each time she studied in the chemical, as well as she's taken some advices from the doctors, doctor research area, then she studied this structure. A detailed conclusion was given in that paper regarding the healthy and enzyme affected alveoli of human lungs. Keeping the data, this data, further study can be carried out with may be useful to the medical personnel. Interpretation of the indices with respect to the healthy and affected alveoli are discussed. Further, this study can be considered into 3D structure of alveoli of human lungs, which will be accurate than the 2D structure considered in their study. And one more paper under the discussion with the relation between the phenylene and hexagon squeeze using harmonic index is studied by the authors, that Usha and their collaborators. That paper is published in International Journal of Graph Theory. The many citations appear for this paper. This is the phenylene and hexagon squeeze. They are taken for study. And these compounds are benzene structure, which are explained as hexagon squeeze is obtained by squeezing the squares from the phenylene, which will be benzenoid structure. The join of the lines or bonds of the chemical compound is considered as a vertex. and the bonds of the compound are treated as the edges. The degrees of each vertex are taken into account, and for all the edges, then the topological indices are determined. Also, the relation between the indices are established by comparing the indices for both the compounds under the study. These are the two simple applications I given. And now I will discuss about a method for developing new topological indices in GraphQL. First, you can check out the direct structure interpretation, good correlation with at least one property, good discrimination of isomer, locally defined, generalizable to higher analogs, linearly independent, not trivially related to other indices, efficiency of construction based on familiar structural concepts, gradual change with gradual change in structures, and applications related to QSPR analysis, mathematical properties, characterization of XML graph, characterization of graph with equal degree based TIs, graph operations. These are the fundamental things for defining the topological indices. And also, nowadays, some of the softwares are also utilized for finding the topological indices. These are some of them, utilizing the Maple for plotting graph, Mathematica, MATLAB, SPSS, Python, MathChem, and so on. The following are the two main uses of the software for investigating topological indices. This is a statistical package for SPSS. We can find correlation regression, linear regression model, standard error. In MathChem, Python package and Dragon software, calculating topological indices as well as properties of topological indices. SageMath is one of the open software help us to construct a graph networks and calculate the topological indices. Graph visualization can be done. That is a Sage is a useful. There is no basic, a basic and no frill visualization. A single command suffice. You can see this is the one of the examples related to using Sage software. And this is a valuable tool for visualizing the results of certain functions. Here we highlight an independent set also. This is the one of the visualization in a Sage software, independent set. And these are the some of the commands for modification of a graph structure as a Sage math. Using this, you can find many things, loops, name, and networking, and weighted adjacency matrix, and many more are available in the Sage math commands. And these are the basic properties of molecule objects as a SageMath command. And this is the code for calculating topological indices. Import MathChem, MathChem.mol, and this is the structure. Return to this, you get a carbon skeleton of 3,4 dimethylene hexagene. And after calculation, in the Zagreb index, you get directly the values. And these are the list of topological indices and its class methods are mentioned here, some of them. And these topological indices are tested in a international society of chemical society, a chemical analytics in Iran. There are 146 indices are well tested and balanced also. In that, these are the presents are there. Python package for calculating topological indices and provided example of its joint use with other well-known open source products such as SageMath. MathChem package does not solve problems out of the box, but instead it provides a flexible and easily expandable framework for computational research in mathematical chemistry. These These are the some motivation thing I done. Thank you. Any questions?
So thank you so much, sir. Questions? I'm just checking out if it is there any questions.
Yes, ma'am. We are just checking the questions.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, is there any questions, ma'am?
No, ma'am.
No questions. Okay. So fine, sir. Thank you so much for your wonderful talk on applications of graph theory and also the topological indices. And I think you have also correlated this with the physics, chemistry, and also the mathematics. And thank you very much for letting us the software that is Sage Math and also the Python. Moreover, you have given the commands. I mean, you have shown, you have explained about the commands on Sage Math also. So thank you so much for having your wonderful talk, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much for giving an opportunity to share my views. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Doraiswamy, sir, I want to speak to you, sir.
Lokesh sir, I am delightful to your speech.
Thank you, sir.
What you are explaining, they are all correlated to physics, chemistry, even engineering also. Yes, sir. Is it? You explained all those things. We are very much proud of you on the behalf of East Point College of Engineering and Technology. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Bye,
sir. Okay, sir. Bye, sir. Bye. 1 minute.
Sir, yes, sir. Now I request Dr. Rangaraju, sir, for having vote of thanks. I'll hand over to him.
Good morning to one and all present here. On this wonderful occasion, I would like to present the vote of thanks. On behalf of East Point College of Engineering and Technology, I take this golden opportunity to thank the respected guest and keynote speaker. Today's program, Dr. Lokesh V, Department of Professor and Chairman, Department of Mathematics, Sri Krishna Deva University, Ballari. So we are grateful to you, sir, for a very inspiring and motivating speech for our students and faculties. So we thank you, sir, for spending your valuable time for the cause of our institution and students. I would like to pay tribute and thanks for the blessing of our founder chairman, Dr. S.M. Venkatapathiji, for his invaluable service to the society through education by establishing East Point Group of Institution. We express our sincere thanks to our honorable chairperson of EPGI, Srimati B.L. Ramadevi, and our CEOs, Sri Pramod Gowda and Sri Raji Gowda, for their support and encouragement in organizing this conference. We thank with gratitude our respected principal, Dr. Prakash S., for constantly supporting and giving lot of encouragement in conducting many important programs. Our sincere thanks to the head of the Basic Science Department, Dr. G. Maruti, sir, Dr. Doraiswamy, and Dr. Shukla, sir, all the HODs and faculty members for their support and coordination in making the event successful. Last but not least, our sincere thanks to our students, especially thanking to everyone who have contributed to the success of this program. Thank you. Once again, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Lokesh sir, once again.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rangaraja sir, for your vote of thanks. And sir, I would like to announce that the next from actually it was about to start from 11 o'clock. So from 11:15, the technical session of day two will start for the paper presentation. So thank you, everyone. Thanks a lot.
Yes,
thank you, Shilpa ma'am.
No problem, ma'am. Okay. I'll end the broadcast.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.